If you were to stand in the center of the Google Quantum AI lab in Santa Barbara, the first thing you would notice is not the futuristic hum of a sci-fi supercomputer, but the sound of rhythmic, mechanical chirping, the pulse tubes of the dilution refrigerators, breathing steadily as they push the temperature of a tiny silicon chip down to near absolute zero. It is a sound that has become the heartbeat of a new era in physics, a steady drumbeat marking time in a world where time itself behaves in ways that defy our intuition. Over the last few months, the digital world outside those laboratory walls has been screaming. You have seen the headlines in your feed, the thumbnails glowing with neon text warning of a godlike discovery, of a machine that has broken physics, of a portal opened to parallel universes. The algorithm feeds us fear and awe in equal measure, telling us that humanity has finally tripped a wire we cannot uncross. But here, in the quiet, chilled air of the lab, the reality is not a ghost story. It is something far more intricate, far more difficult, and ultimately, far more profound. The subject of this global fervor is a processor named Willow. It is a chip no larger than a postage stamp, etched with 105 superconducting qubits. And in late 2025, it performed an experiment that didn't break physics, but verified it with a level of precision that was previously thought impossible. They call it quantum echoes. And while the internet debates whether we have invented a time machine, the physicists know we have done something arguably more important. We have built a ruler. A ruler made of quantum states, capable of measuring the chaos of the universe and, for the briefest of moments, reversing it. This is the true story of the Willow chip, not the myth, but the machine. This is how we move from the age of guessing to the age of verification. To truly understand the weight of this moment, we have to look back at the road that brought us here. For the last decade, quantum computing has been stuck in a purgatory known as the NISQ era, noisy intermediate scale quantum technology. It was a period defined by a tantalizing but frustrating paradox. We could build quantum processors, we could entangle qubits, and we could run algorithms, but we couldn't trust them. The quantum state is a fragile thing, a delicate house of cards built on the edge of a cliff. Thermal noise, electromagnetic interference, even a stray cosmic ray from deep space can cause decoherence, collapsing the complex, multidimensional quantum state into a pile of classical randomness. For years, the skeptics argued that this noise was insurmountable, that building a large-scale quantum computer was like trying to carry a tray of crystal glasses through a mosh pit without breaking a single stem. The holy grail was fault tolerance, or at the very least, a verifiable quantum advantage. A moment where a quantum machine could do something useful, something complex, and crucially, something we could prove was correct. In 2019, Google's Sycamore processor claimed quantum supremacy with 53 qubits in a random circuit sampling experiment. It was a Wright brothers moment, a proof of flight, but it was controversial. The calculation was so complex that classical supercomputers struggled to check the work. It was a black box. We knew it was fast, but we struggled to prove it was right. Enter Willow. Unveiled to the world in late 2025, the Willow architecture represents a generational leap in superconducting processor design. On the surface, the numbers tell a story of scale. Sycamore had 53 qubits. Willow has 105. In the binary world of classical computing, a doubling of bits is a modest upgrade. But in the exponential world of quantum mechanics, adding 50 qubits doesn't double the power. It expands the state space by a factor of 2 to the power of 50. To put that in perspective, the state space of the Willow chip, the number of configurations it can explore simultaneously is, that number is vast. It is larger than the number of atoms in the visible universe. If you turned every atom in every star in every galaxy into a hard drive, you still wouldn't have enough storage to write down the state of this one chip when it is fully entangled. But as any quantum engineer will tell you, qubit count is a vanity metric. It's the megapixel war of the quantum world, good for marketing, bad for science, if the pixels are blurry. A machine with 1,000 noisy, error-prone qubits is infinitely less useful than a machine with 50 pristine ones. You can have all the parallel universes you want, but if you can't get an answer out of them, they are worthless. The genius of Willow is not its size, it is its silence. The architecture features a new coupling design that dramatically reduces the crosstalk between qubits. Imagine trying to have 105 separate conversations in a crowded room. On previous chips, when qubit A talked to qubit B, qubit C would overhear it and get confused. That is cross-talk. Willow's average connectivity of 3.47 allows for a dense, highly interconnected lattice where qubits can be entangled in complex geometries, yet the isolation protocols ensure that errors don't cascade through the system like a contagion. This error mitigation is the bedrock of the verifiable nature of the recent discovery. It is what allowed Google to run the Quantum Echoes algorithm, a task that requires the machine to maintain coherence, not just forward in time, but effectively backward in a thermodynamic sense. This is where the hardware meets the hype. This is the physical platform that allowed us to run the code that scared the internet. So, let's deconstruct the Quantum Echoes algorithm. This is the heart of the godlike claim, the source of the time reversal rumors. To understand it, we have to talk about chaos. In physics, chaos isn't just disorder, it's the rapid scrambling of information. Think of the classic butterfly effect. A butterfly flaps its wings in Brazil and causes a tornado in Texas. In a quantum system, this scrambling happens when information spreads from one qubit to the entire system, becoming irretrievable to a local observer. The Quantum Echoes experiment is designed to measure this scrambling using a tool called an out-of-time order correlator, or OTOC. The analogy used by the researchers is evocative and precise. Imagine a calm, glassy pond. You throw a pebble into the center, ripples spread out, intersecting, reflecting off the banks, becoming a complex, chaotic pattern of peaks and troughs. If you look at the pond 5 minutes later, you can't tell where the pebble landed. The information has been scrambled. Now, imagine you possess a godlike power, the ability to instantly reverse the velocity of every single water molecule in that pond. If you did this perfectly, the ripples would move backward. They would untangle themselves, converging back toward the center, until times bloop times the pebble shoots out of the water and back into your hand. This is the echo. In the classical world, this is impossible. Entropy, the measure of disorder, always increases. You can't unbreak an egg. You can't unspill the milk. But in the hermetically sealed, coherent world of the Willow chip, the laws of thermodynamics can be toyed with. The researchers initialized the 105 qubits into a known state. They then applied a unitary evolution, a series of quantum gates that acted like the passage of time, scrambling the information across the chip. This is the forward ripples. Then, they did something subtle. They applied a tiny perturbation, a butterfly wing flap, to just a single qubit. If the system were classical, this tiny change would be lost in the noise. But then, they ran the evolution in reverse. They applied the mathematical inverse of all the previous operations. They reversed the ripples. And they listened. If the chip was perfect, if the quantum coherence held, the system would return to its initial state. but with a specific difference caused by that tiny butterfly wing flap. The magnitude of that difference is the echo. The result was staggering. The willow chip caught the echo. It successfully unscrambled the information, bringing the system back to its origin, with a fidelity that allowed the researchers to measure the specific decay caused by that single qubit perturbation. This is the godlike discovery. It isn't that they built a time machine to travel to the past. It's that they built a system so isolated from the noise of the universe, so perfectly controlled, that they could reverse the flow of entropy within that system. They demonstrated that the butterfly effect in a quantum system is not just a metaphor, but a measurable physical quantity. And the speed, that is the headline you saw. In performing this specific benchmark, the Willow chip was 13,000 times faster than the world's most powerful classical supercomputers. We are talking about the difference between a calculation taking hours on a localized cluster versus milliseconds on Willow. This 13,000x figure is verified. It is the transition from "we think this works" to "we can prove this works better than anything else." But why does this matter? Why should you, sitting at home, care about ripples in a quantum pond? Because this echo is more than a party trick. It is a molecular ruler. This is the part the viral videos often skip, but it is the part that will actually change your life. In the world of chemistry and materials science, understanding the structure of complex molecules is everything. It is the key to designing better batteries, more efficient solar panels, and most importantly, drugs that can cure diseases like Alzheimer's or cancer. Currently, we use a technique called nuclear magnetic resonance, NMR, spectroscopy, to figure out the shape of molecules. It works by detecting the magnetic spins of atoms. But for large, complex proteins, the signals get messy. They get scrambled, just like the ripples in the pond. The quantum echoes algorithm allows us to take that messy, scrambled signal and mathematically reverse it, filtering out the noise to reveal the precise distance between atoms. It allows us to see the geometry of a molecule with a clarity that was previously physically impossible. Willow isn't just a computer. It is a microscope for the building blocks of reality. This verification brings us to a philosophical edge that explains why the godlike label stuck. When Hartmut Neven, the founder of Google Quantum AI, spoke about Willow, he said that its success lends credence to the notion that quantum computation occurs in many parallel universes. He was referencing the many worlds interpretation of quantum mechanics, a theory first proposed by Hugh Everett in the 1952. The idea is that every time a quantum particle interacts, the universe splits. In one timeline, the spin is up. In another, it is down. Neven's point is that the computational space Willow explores, that massive state space, is so vast that it is hard to imagine it fitting inside a single classical reality. When Willow performs a calculation, it is surfing the waves of these probabilities, exploring paths that branch out like a fractal tree. The echo is the proof that these paths exist, that they are real, and that we can reach into that multiverse of possibilities and pull out a single, hard truth. It is a vertigo-inducing thought. The machine on the table is small, but the shadow it casts is infinite. However, we must remain grounded. The viral warning videos often imply that Willow has become sentient, or that it has unlocked a danger we cannot control. This is the Frankenstein trope, reskinned for the 21st century. The reality is that Willow is a tool, and, like all tools, it has limits. It is still sensitive to noise. The 13,000x speedup applies to this specific type of problem, simulating quantum dynamics. You cannot install Windows on Willow. You cannot run Doom Times on it, at least. Not in the way you think. It is a specialized engine designed to do one thing: model the quantum nature of the universe. But that one thing is the foundation of everything else. By simulating nature at its most fundamental level, we are essentially gaining the admin passwords to matter itself. The fear comes from the fact that we are no longer just observers of the universe. We are becoming active participants in its source code. As we look toward 2026, the roadmap is clear. The NISQ era is ending. The fault-tolerant era is dawning. Competitors like Quantinuum are launching their own high-fidelity systems, creating a new space race not for territory, but for logic. We are entering a quantum Moore's law, where the power of these machines will double not in years, but in months. The Willow chip is not the end of the line. It is the Model T. It is the proof that the engine works. The godlike discovery of 2025 was not magic. It was engineering. It was the result of thousands of humans striving to build a quiet place in a noisy universe, a place where we could finally hear the echo of our own questions returning to us with an answer. We haven't broken reality. We have just cleaned the lens. And, for the first time in human history, we are seeing the universe not as it appears to be, but as it actually is, a vibrating, entangled ocean of possibility, waiting for us to learn how to swim. The implications of this extend far beyond the laboratory. If we can verify quantum advantage in thermodynamic simulations, what prevents us from simulating more complex systems? We are approaching a horizon where the simulation of a virus, a climate system, or even a neural network becomes indistinguishable from the thing itself. The Echoes experiment proved that information can be scrambled and unscrambled without loss, challenging our understanding of entropy and the arrow of time. It hints at a deep connection between quantum information and the fabric of space-time itself, touching on the very theories that describe black holes. In a black hole, information is thought to be scrambled on the event horizon. By building a machine that can de-scramble information, we are, in a metaphorical sense, building a laboratory black hole. We are testing the physics of the extreme in a controlled environment. This is why the scientists are excited. This is why the internet is terrified. And this is why you should be paying attention. So, the next time you see a video warning you about the terrifying new quantum AI, remember the Willow chip. Remember the pulsing tubes and the silent superconducting aluminum loops. Remember that the terror is just the vertigo of progress. We are standing on the shore of a vast, dark ocean. For centuries, we have only been able to look at the waves on the surface. Now, we have thrown a stone, and for the first time, we have heard the bottom. The echo has returned. The map is being drawn, and the journey is just beginning.